Hi all, this is Mohit Rathi and I welcome you all to my advanced Facebook and Instagram ads course in 2020. So it is a 6-hour course which covers from beginner to mastery level. If you go through the entire course, you will be able to run any kind of campaign on Facebook and Instagram. Okay, so we'll quickly get started with this course then. So before we get started, why you should be using Facebook and Instagram ads? So, or who should be using it? So I have put down only 3 categories of people who should be using Facebook and Instagram ads. Number 1, small business owners. Number 2, big brands. And number 3, freelancers. Now for small business owners, why is it important? Because they want to generate more sales. And only if sales comes in, their revenue is going to pump up and they are going to survive into the market. And for freelancers, when I tell freelancers, it includes your photographers, web designers, makeup artists, and any other freelancer. And why do they need Facebook and Instagram ads? In order to generate more leads. And for big brands, so that they can build a connect, they can connect to their audience, they can have a rapport, they can maintain loyalty, etc., etc. It is more on the awareness level. They want to create awareness about their upcoming products, connect with people, etc. So this are the 3 kinds of people who should definitely be using Facebook and Instagram ads. Now we'll quickly get started over here. So let's see what is the course overview. So I have 12 different modules to be covered. Module number 1 is setting up your business page and then using Boost Post, Advanced Ads Manager, Facebook Pixel, Remarketing. So as and when we go down, we'll look into other modules also. For today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do module number 1 and module number 2. That is setting up your business page and understanding the Boost Post concept. This is the fundamentals. So let's get started with setting up the business page. Cool. So I would like to go to Google Chrome. Once you go to Google Chrome, this is your Facebook account. Once you log in into a Facebook account, on the top, you would have this option called as create. Under create, you will find something called as page. So once you click on page, you'll be on a screen like this. So there will be 2 different categories to choose from. Is it a business or brand? Is it a community or public figure? So if in case you're creating a page for your personal account, that is your personal portfolio or something like Mohit Rathi, that time I'll go for community or public figure. Or if it is a business or brand, you have a local business, you have a physical location, and then it goes under business or brand. Click on get started, write a page name, write a category, and then click on continue. So once you fill in the basic details, then you would be on a page like this. So this is an already created page that I'm showing you right over here. So once you go over here on the top, this is called as the admin bar. This is called as the admin bar. So on the admin bar, first click on settings. It is very important that you configure a little of essential settings. So I'll go to settings. Under general, the page visibility. Before even you start with the advertisements, it is very important that your page is published. And then if I scroll down a little more important options are country restrictions. If you want your page not to be visible in certain countries, so you can give country restrictions on those pages. And then you also have age restrictions over here. Left hand side, there is something called as page rules. So once you click on page rules, here you will be able to add multiple number of people who can manage the page. If you see, as of now, I have 3 different people who are managing this page. Why is it important to add multiple number of people? It's simply because if you have lost the credentials of your Facebook account, or if your Facebook account is blocked, the page also gets blocked. So it is always a good practice to have at least 2 admins. Otherwise, you can give people other role also: editor, moderator, advertiser, analyst, etc., etc., etc. Okay, and then you have something called as page info. So once you get into page info, here you will be able to write about your page, that what this page is all about. You'll be able to update your website, phone number, street address, etc. So all of these are basic settings. So I want you guys to go over here and explore all of the settings, because there is no point me explaining all of them. Okay, so you'll have to go over here and explore all of them. We'll come back to page over here. Once you come back to page over here, so this is the most important timeline over here. So this page is your page. Whatever you post comes right over here. Cool. So what I want you guys to do is, first you will have to go ahead and post some photo right over here. Otherwise we call it as anything on your timeline, some status or something, that should also be fine. Once you have posted it, you will get this option called as Boost Post. Okay, so we'll learn how exactly this boost post works. So once you click on boost post, you will have number one, select the objective. Okay, now boost post is a very basic method of running advertisements on Facebook. So first we'll get started with boost post and try to understand this before we jump into the advanced ads manager. In boost post, step number one is select the objective. Now, what is an objective? It is nothing but why do you want to run an advertisement? And you have only two objectives over here. Number one, you want more engagement. Engagement simply means you want more people to like it, more people to share it. So like, comment, share is called as engagement. Number two, message. Okay, you want people to swipe up and go to the messenger and drop you a message on the messenger. So that is called as connect and chat with your potential customers. So let's select as of now, get more likes, share and comment, etc. Then you scroll down a little. Here comes the most important part, audience. Okay, now audience is basically to whom do you want to show this particular advertisement. I would click over here, create new audience. Okay, and then I'll be on a screen like this. Audience name is for my internal reference. So I will call it as, let's say, I'll call it as wedding services audience. Okay, so basically I run a company, I'm assuming that I run a company which is into wedding services. That is photography, makeup artists. We provide all-in-one package for everything. So we are trying to target people who are looking for wedding services. Okay. Now, when it comes to audience, there are four ways this audience is divided into. That is basic demographics, advanced demographics, interest-based targeting, and behavioral targeting. Basic demographics simply refers to gender, age, and location. So I want to target all men and women between 20 to 40 who live in Bangalore. So it says my potential audience size is somewhere close to 65 lakh. Okay, so this is called as basic demographics. I can change the age to 20 to, let's say, 45. And instead of Bangalore, I can select some other city also. Let's say I want to select Mumbai. Then the potential audience size comes right over here. Okay, so let's again go back and change it from Mumbai to, let's say, Bangalore. Okay, now you see there are 70 lakh people who have a Facebook account in Bangalore and who fall under this age category, 20 to 45. So does it make sense to target all the 70 lakh people? It doesn't, right? So there comes the option of more targeting options, which is under browse. So the first targeting option is simple demographics or basic demographics. That is nothing but the age, location, and gender. And then you have three more options. That is advanced demographics, interest-based targeting, and behavior-based targeting. Okay, so let's get into advanced demographics first. So once you click on demographics, here you can target people on the basis of their education level, on the basis of finance is not available for India, so let's ignore that. Life event, somebody who is away from family. So let's say if I click away from family, it says 370,000 people. So instead of targeting all the 70 lakh people, now we are targeting only 370,000 people. But why do you want to target people who are away from family? Which business? For which business it might be? Possibly you are running some tiffin services, some dabba services in Bangalore to deliver tiffins, etc., etc. So that time you can target people who are away from family. I'll remove this off, remove this filter. You can also go ahead and target people on the basis of birthday, upcoming birthday, people who have their upcoming birthday. You can also target friends of close friends of people who have an upcoming birthday. So possibly this is for a business like bakery. If in case you are running a bakery and you want people to buy cakes for their friends on their birthdays, etc., etc., you can target this category of people. And then I'll scroll down a little. Yeah, over here you see newly engaged within 1 year, newly engaged within 3 months, and newly engaged within 6 months. So it shows me there are around 8,000 people. However, it also shows me that I'm going very much specific. So here you will see too specific, you will see something called as broad, and then you will see something called as good. Okay, so whenever you're trying to go more specific, the cost of advertisement is going to increase. And whenever you're trying to go too much broad, what happens is the audience is not that great. Okay, So it is always a good practice to be in good. But since wedding services and not, I don't know what type of audience will work well for them, I can always try 2 to 3 different audiences. So one of my audience will be too specific, and one of my audience will be a little much on the good side of it, etc., etc., etc. But before we finalize on this audience, I'll again go ahead, click on browse. I'll again go back to demographics. Okay. You can also target parents, by the way. So you can target parents who has a 3 to 5 year old kid, parent who has a 9 to 8 year old kid. So let's say 3 to 5 year old kid. So the figure changed from 18,000 to 23,000. So 23 minus 8, that many new audiences added. Now, why do you want to target parents with preschoolers? Possibly you are running swimming classes, karate classes, football classes, etc., etc. So that time this audience becomes much more important. So let's say I can even select 9 to 12 and then it becomes 41,000, and which says it is well defined. The size is well defined. So this is how you select your audience, and again click on browse. After demographics, you have interest-based targeting. So interest-based targeting is basically what people are interested in. I personally don't like this particular audience type because you see what happens is not too many people have updated their interest on Facebook. But there is another theory which says that Facebook actually sees what kind of pages that you follow, and based upon that you are put into this categories. So sometimes it works very well. But for me, interest-based targeting is the last option that I would be opting for. Okay, so I want you guys to go ahead and explore interest-based targeting on your own. The most important option for me is behavior-based targeting. So behavior is basically what type of mobile device people are using, okay, and what type of goods they prefer, people who prefer high-value goods, mid-value goods, etc., etc. So let's say I go over here and click on mobile device user. I can click on mobile device by brand. I can click on Apple, and then I can select people who own Apple iPhone XR. So the figure changed from 41,000 to 57,000. So that means it added another 18,000, another 16,000 people in the audience. Okay. Now, why do you want to target people who own Apple iPhone XR? Let's remove all of this and let's keep only Apple iPhone XR. Okay. Let me go back to this edit here. Yeah. Why do you want to target people who own Apple iPhone XR? Possibly you are selling back cases of Apple iPhone XR, and this is the audience that would be purchasing that. Or if in case you would think that the creamy layer of the society lies in the iOS section, so you can target everybody who uses say iOS mobile phone or OnePlus 7, OnePlus 6. All of that is possible from behavior-based targeting. And that is the reason why behavior-based targeting is one of my personal favorites. You can scroll down, travel. People who returned from travel 1 week ago, frequent international travelers, commuters, etc., etc., everything over here. Now you see, this audience is called as the secret sauce of every digital marketer. No digital marketer is going to share with you what audience he uses. Okay. It is the secret sauce of every digital marketer. So I want you guys to spend some time around it. First, take down an Excel sheet and write all of these options in an Excel sheet, so that you know that what and all classification is available, etc., etc., etc. So once this is done, I'm going to click on save. The potential audience size is 15,000, which is very good. And let's click on save. And then you'll have to scroll down a little over here. Then it will ask you what is the duration, for how many days do you want to run advertisement. So let's say you want to run it for 1 day. By the way, the minimum spend on Facebook and Instagram is 40 rupees per day. But for some accounts, it is increased to 80 rupees per day. So you'll find either 40 rupees per day has minimum spend or 80 rupees per day has minimum spend. So let's say if I spend 100 rupees, how many people will see this advertisement? Around 860 to 2,500 people will see this advertisement. But there, the potential audience size was 16,000. Okay, now if you want to show your advertisement to all the 16,000 people, you will have to increase your budget. Itne paise mein itna hi aayega, theek hai? So I'll again make it 100 rupees. So for 100 rupees, 860 people to 2,500, which is a very, very good figure, guys. If in case you consider sending people SMS, etc. It is going to cost you much more higher. Now, this many people are going to see the advertisement. They are not going to click on it. So we call it as impressions. Okay, people are going to see it. There are higher chances that people are going to just skip it. Okay, they are going to just scroll through it or go to the next story. So, but this figure is also 860 to 2500. Why is there so much of difference? 860 kahan pe hai aur 2500 kahan pe hai? Okay, now if in case the ad quality, that is the one over here, if this is not that good, that time it will be shown only to 860 people. But if in case people are engaging with your advertisement, they are liking your ad copy, that time it will be shown up to 2500 people. Okay, so basically Facebook doesn't want to show bad quality advertisements to its users. Okay, so the basic thing is you'll have to design a very good ad copy. So get your graphic designer to the task or go to canva.com and create some good ad copies. Try it over a period of time. So you will get how many impressions? 860 since you are paying money. But if your ad copy is very good, that time you will get up to 2500 impressions. Now comes the next question. Out of 2500 people, how many people are going to click on it? Okay, so usually the cost per click on Facebook for a beginner might range from 2 rupees to 5 rupees. So aapko 100 rupees mein lagbhag mil jayenge aapko 50 click ya usse thodi kam click, 40 to 50 clicks aapko mil jayenge. But over a period of time, if you keep improving, your cost per click can go down till 50 paise. Okay, I'll show you some of my advertisement at the later part of this course, wherein the cost per click of my advertisement has gone down up to 60 paise. And that is what I want you guys also to achieve. But for now, in the beginning, just assume that it will be 2 rupees to 5 rupees per click, which is also a very decent figure. Okay, so once this is done, all that you're supposed to do is click on boost post. And let's see if the payment method is added over here. Yeah, there is a payment method which is already added over here, and the budget and the tax. Once you click on boost post, so this is going to be there. It will take around 24 hours for this advertisement to go live. But before that, I'll just go and change the audience because the audience was iPhone XR. I'll have to change that. Yes, but 95% of times I never use boost post. Okay, there is something called as Advanced Ads Manager, and that is the one which I usually use. So in the next video, I'm going to talk about the Advanced Ads Manager, which is used 95% of the times. But before I do that, I want you guys to go ahead, click on boost post and try to understand all the audience type. Make a note of them in an Excel sheet. Okay, so I'll see you guys in the next video then. Thank you. Thank you for watching.